Tässä on Mariko. Katso Staraa. Please enjoy my album.
Waking Up in Vegas is a song about spontaneity. In living in Los Angeles, you get the opportunity to have a couple of beers, and if you want to go to Vegas, you get in a car, you have someone drive you, mind you, and you go to Vegas, and probably halfway in, you're like, why did I decide that this was a good idea? But, you know, it doesn't matter if you're going to Vegas or anything. When you know you're going to get into, like, a hairy situation, you just got to go for it. It's like toilet papering somebody's house. You know you're going to get caught, but you just do it anyway. If you want me. My idols are wide range. My very biggest idol and influential person in my life as far as music is concerned was Freddie Mercury from Queen, being very flamboyant and colorful and really being himself. Then I started listening to the Beach Boys, then I started listening to Heart, Jonathan Brooke and Patti Griffin and Jeff Buckley and Alanis Morissette, Jagged Little Pill. Like, you know how everybody has that one quote of like, I like everything besides country. I'm like, hells no, I love Carrie Underwood. I like everything. If it's a good song, I don't care if it's metal or if it's poke. If it's a good song, it works. Don't play cheap with your heart, don't make a mess. The ultimate dream band. This is gonna take a second. Little Richard on keys. Taylor Hawkins on drums, John Mayer on guitar, and the Supremes as my backup singer. When I had a bunch of girls on stage singing I Kissed a Girl and, you know, just watching people like crowd surf and get crazy like bananas, that's insane. But there was one girl that's getting her whole back. A mural tattoo of the album cover, and she's just started, and she has the one of the boys on the top already, and some stars and the birds. That is dedication. You're so gay and you don't even like boys. When I heard Madonna liked my song, it was kind of like, you know, everybody has that Madonna poster on their wall, and they have that dream about their icon kind of leaping out of the picture and kind of talking to them and having that moment. And I felt like that actually happened to me in my life. It was Madonna, and she knew my first and last name. And I don't know if it meant anything to her, you know, dropping my name or what have you, but it really, like, changed up my game. I mean, when she speaks, people listen. Most flattering comparison that I've heard. You know, I hear Joan Jett a little bit here and there. And I think we have the black hair and the kind of rocker appeal. And some people say sometimes, you know, I don't want to go so far as to say I am like her because she is a being of her own, Karen O from the IAS. But like, I try and have the same energy level, spontaneity level, and keep everybody kind of going, like, what is she going to do next? What is she going to do next? I think those are mine, too, probably. I've heard that I'm like, are you sure? The stereotype. I love going anywhere that really embraces their culture and has a thick sense of culture. My favorite place to go, I have been before, and every time I go, I freak out, is Tokyo. When they said I was going to go to Japan, I was like, well, that's great, but I'm gonna need 2 days off in Tokyo because I gotta go to Kirby Land. And that's 5 stories of tons and tons of toys. I gotta make my mark.